Jeffree Star called out NYX Cosmetics, and some people are canceling the brand. Before I get into the tea, I just want to put out a disclaimer. Please do not send any hate to Jeffree Star, NYX, or anyone else involved in this controversy. This video is simply meant to report on the news and give some insight on the issue. On September 9th, Jeffree Star wrote a tweet saying NYX attempted to claim a Lime Crime product as their own. He wrote, "Do these brands really think we're stupid? NYX Cosmetics just tried to act like these old Lime Crime lip swatches were theirs and deleted it after I said something. Girl, bye." The deleted tweet asked people what their favorite NYX lip shade is and used a gif of Lime Crime's lip shades. The lip shades belong to Lime Crime's Pop Romance campaign from March 2011. NYX tweeted back, "Mondays, am I right? Thanks for catching." Someone said the GIF was taken from Giphy, a website that allows people to find and create GIFs for free. The person wrote, "When you type in lipstick into the search bar on GIF, this is one of the first ones that pop up. I don't think they made the video with the intention to steal the swatches. I think their marketing person just added it for fun. It's unclear who created the GIF and if others are legally allowed to use it, since Giphy does not require that information before uploading. All we know is the person who uploaded the GIF listed a Tumblr page as the source called Pastel Inspiration." Mosh, the model featured in the campaign, said the image has appeared everywhere in print and online. On National Lipstick Day, she posted the image on Instagram and wrote, "This photo magically appeared on everything, from shirts and pants sold in Chinatown, to home decor and online fashion ads, and was also the inspiration for a small part of Meghan Trainor's fun hit music video All About That Bass." Some people said they were canceling NYX, and they should be using their own photos on Twitter. NYX ripping off Lime Crime? Who the f*** do they think they are? If this is an actual thing, I'm not buying NYX products any more. The post specifically asked for your favorite NYX shade, so why use a random GIF that isn't your own shade? It's laziness that got them in trouble. As a photographer, this would infuriate me. Not only is it unprofessional, it's illegal. That is someone's copyrighted material. Others were sympathetic and asked people not to cancel the company and remember that mistakes happen. Stop with that cancel. People forget there's someone behind the screen. Mistakes happen. Everyone is too quick to play the cancel card. How would it feel if you had a long day at work, mess up on accident, and everyone is up your and you can't do anything about it? Not denying it was stupid on Nick's part, but this GIF is available on several platforms without going to LC's website. Social media marketer here. I do agree whoever runs the NYX account should have definitely used the brand's own images, made their own GIF, or at least put research into the image they decided to use, because in that position, you should be promoting your own products and staying on brand. However, I think we can have some grace for human beings who make mistakes. That seems to be the end of the situation for now. So, what's the big issue? There are a few. The rise of cancel culture, the murky waters of copyright laws, and how Giphy's terms of use work. It's the first time that NYX has been canceled by so many people, which is an issue that companies shouldn't take lightly. Lisa Nakamura, the director of the Digital Studies Institute at the University of Michigan, describes the term as a cultural boycott. In an interview with the New York Times, she said, "It's an agreement not to amplify, signal boost, give money to. People talk about the attention economy. When you deprive someone of your attention, you're depriving them of a livelihood." The term is said to have come from Black Twitter, a group of individuals who come together to have conversations about everything, from culture to race to identity. Over the years, more people have been using the term and dozens of companies and celebrities have been canceled, including SoulCycle, Equinox, In-N-Out, Taylor Swift, Kanye West, and Kevin Hart. Aisha Remy, a writer who has blogged about cancel culture, said, "Because canceling takes place online, it can have a worldwide effect." She said, "When someone's canceled on Black American Twitter, they tend to be canceled on Black UK Twitter. If more people cancel NYX, it could damage their brand and hurt its sales." Even worse, Lime Crime might be able to take legal action against them. Leslie Ellen, a copyright lawyer, said there are only a few exceptions where people don't need permission to legally use an image. If the image they're using is in the public domain, including a US federal government image, if a non-government employee, such as a consultant, assigned rights to the US government, if the copyright owner has clearly stated that others can freely use the image without their permission, If they made a fair use analysis and are comfortable that their use falls within the US fair use provision, and if the image has a Creative Commons license. Given the little information available, it isn't clear if Nix or the person who created the GIF fall under these exceptions. What is clear is that if Lime Crime decides to take legal action against Giphy, Giphy doesn't have to worry about financial losses. In Giphy's terms of service, they state, "We hope this never comes up, but just in case it does, you agree to reimburse us for any loss we suffer that is tied to your use or misuse of the services, violation of this agreement, or infringement of any third party's right." They also state that users must own the content they contribute and shouldn't use the content in any way that violates third-party rights. If you miss their terms of service, you might not be the only one. On Giphy's homepage, you first need to click on a three-dot icon before finding the link to their terms of service, which appears at the bottom. Typically, websites ask people to review and agree to their terms of service before using their products or services. Giphy doesn't ask people to sign up to use their services, and instead has their terms of service buried in a hard-to-find menu. Companies should maintain best practices for branding and use their own images on social media, especially if they're asking the public which of their products is their favorite. While it appears that Nix made an honest mistake, their social media team should have done their homework to make sure the image doesn't hurt their branding or mislead the public. After all, Nix is owned by L'Oreal, the world's largest beauty conglomerate, and reportedly earns an estimated $148 million in annual revenue, whereas Lime Crime reportedly earns only $2.5 million in comparison. Nix could afford to use their own images or give credit where it's due. What do you think about this story? Do you think Nix made a mistake? Let me know in the comments below.